各位晚上好，中英文读书第六讲现在开始。今天的题目是《The Safe Living Guide》安全生活指南，《Public Health Agency of Canada》加拿大公共健康署。A Guide to Home Safety for Seniors 老年人家居安全指南 Objectives 目标 To promote and protect the health of Canadians through leadership, partnership, innovation and action in Public Health Agency of Canada 通过领导力、伙伴关系、创新和公共卫生行动来促进和保护加拿大人的健康。加拿大公共卫生署 To promote 是领导力 ，innovation 是促进。The Safe Living Guide, a guide to home safety for seniors.Is available on the internet at the following address. 安全生活指南，老年人居家安全指南，可在互联网上查询，网址如下。Seniors 是老年人 ，available 是可获得的，可查询的。这个是网址 ，www.publichealth.gc.ca/seniors。Table of contents 目录，第一部分是讲 There's no place like home, but 一个是没有像家一样的地方，但是第二部分讲的 The facts, seniors and injury in Canada 第二部分是实例分析加拿大人的老年人和受伤第三是 The facts, aging brings changes第三个是实例分析，是老年化带来的变化。第四是 keeping your home safe， 确保您的家庭安全。这部分里面有两个内容，第一个是 outside and inside checklists， 由内由外而内的检查清单。第二个是 Eileen's story， 艾琳的故事。我们这个内容分两部分讲，今天的课就讲到这里。艾琳的故事，下面的内容我们下一堂课再讲。There is no place like home, but 第一部分是讲没有像家一样的地方，但是。There's no place like home, and sometimes it seems like there's no place safer. For seniors, however, the home is where many injuries occur, and most of these are due to falls. Changes that are part of the normal aging process, such as decline, vision, hearing,sense of touch or smell the bone density can increase the risk of injury. Injuries can also be more of a problem for seniors because as the body ages, it takes longer to heal and recover from injury. You must think thataccidents just happened and that nothing can really be done to prevent them. Not so. By taking some simple measures, you can considerably reduce your chance of being injured at home. It's a matter of knowing what the potential hazards are, taking precautions and makingadjustments, these changes can make a big difference. 这里面的生词 injuries occur 发生受伤， process 是过程， decline 是下降， density 是骨密度， potential hazards 是潜在的危害， precaution 是预防措施。没有比家更像家的地方了，有时似乎没有比这更安全的地方了。然而对于老年人来说，家里是发生受伤的地方，其中大部分是由于跌倒造成的。正常衰老过程的变化，如视力、听力、触觉或嗅觉和骨密度下降，会增加受伤的风险。对于老年人来说，受伤也可能是一个更大的问题，因为随着年龄的增长，愈合和从伤害中恢复需要更长的时间。你可能会认为事故只是发生，并且无法真正采取任何措施来预防它们。事实并非如此，通过采取一些简单的措施，您可以大大减少在家中受伤的机会。这是一个了解潜在危害是什么，采取预防措施并进行调整，这些变化可以产生很大的不同。This guide provides advice on how to prevent injuries by keeping your home, yourself, and your environment as safe as you can. Checklists allow you to verify and increase the safety of your surroundings.And lifestyle. And a really life stories offer testimony to the value of adapting. As the old saying goes, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Inspecting your home and taking action to prevent home injuries can help you to live comfortably and safely.For many years to come, we hope you will find this guide to be a practical tool to help you along the way. 这里面是 verify 是验证， surroundings 是周围， ounce 是盎司，就是重量的盎司， inspecting 是检查。第二部分就是讲的本指南提供了有关如何通过尽可能保持房屋自己和环境安全来预防伤害的建议。通过清单，您可以验证和提高周围环境和生活方式的安全性，而现实生活中的故事则证明了调整的价值。正如一句老话所说，一盎司的预防胜过一磅的治疗。检查您的房屋并采取行动防止家中受伤，可以帮助您的未来许多年内舒适安全的生活。我们希望您一路走来，您会发现本指南是有帮助的一个实用的工具。 The facts 实例分析。 Seniors and injury in Canada， 加拿大人的老年人和受伤。第一部分，Falls cause injuries and deaths. 跌倒造成人员伤亡。Falls are the leading cause of injuries among Canadians 65 years and over. Between 20% and 30% of community-dwelling Canadian seniors experience one fall each year.Research suggests that falls are the direct cause of 95% of all hip fractures, leading to death in 20% of cases. 这里面生词是 dwelling 是居住， hip fractures 是髋部骨折。跌倒是65岁及以上加拿大人受伤的主要原因。20%-30%的社区居住的加拿大老年人每年经历了一次跌倒。研究表明，跌倒是95%髋部骨折的直接原因，导致20%的病例死亡。 hospitalization, 第二部分住院。Fourth, account for 85% of seniors injury-related hospitalizations, making this the lead cause of injury-related admissions for seniors. The average Canadian senior had to stay in hospital 10 days longer for falls than for any other cause. Falls are associated with over 1/3 of admissions to long-term care facilities after being released from the hospital. Admissions 是入院，甚至啊，第二部分住院，跌倒在老年人受伤相关住院治疗的 85%， 使其成为老年人受伤相关入院的主要原因。加拿大老年人平均跌倒而不得不住院停留10天，而不是任何其他原因。跌倒与出院后超过1/3的长期护理与入院有关。Cost of injuries, 伤害成本第三。Apart from personal suffering, loss of independence, and the lower quality of life, the costs of seniors' injuries to the health system are enormous. Approximately $2 billion annually is spent on direct health care costs.Enormous 是生词，表示巨大的。除了个人痛苦、丧失独立性和生活质量下降外，老年人对于卫生系统造成的伤害成本是巨大的，每年约有$20亿用于直接医疗保健费用。第四 ，Where injuries occur， 哪里是发生伤害的地方 ？Approximately half of all falls that lead to hospitalization among seniors occur at home. The bathroom and the stairs are particularly hazardous due to the risk of slipping, tripping, and stumbling. Hazardous 是危险 ，slipping 是滑倒 ，tripping 是绊倒 ，stumbling 是困住的意思啊，导致老年人住院的所有跌倒中，约有一半发生在家中。浴室和楼梯特别危险，因为有滑倒、绊倒和困住的风险。Fear of falling， 第五个是害怕跌倒。Seniors who fall may limit their activities for fear of falling again. Yet by limiting activities.They are likely to lose strength and flexibility and increase their risk of falling again. Maintaining physical activity is essential if you wish to prevent falls and injury. So seniors fall in Canada. Strength and flexibility 是力量和灵活性。Essential 是至关重要的意思，至关的，确实的意思。老年人可能会因为害怕再次跌倒而限制他们的活动，然而通过限制活动，他们可能会失去力量和灵活性，并增加再次跌倒的风险。如果您希望防止跌倒和受伤，保持身体活动至关重要。资料来源是加拿大老年人跌倒。Second report available at 第二次报告见网址是这个啊。The fact sits 实例分析第三部分的实例分析 ，Aging brings changes 衰老带来变化。Aging affects each individual differently. Some seniors experience physical limitations.That seriously affect their level of activity, while others are able to remain quite active. The natural process of growing older, however, generally includes changes in abilities. If you are experiencing some of the problems associated with the changes described below, consult your health professional and make sure you undertake whatever changes or adaptations will help you cope and compensate 是补偿。衰老对每个人的影响不同，一些老年人的身体限制严重影响了他们的生活水平，而另一些老年人则能够保持相当活跃。然而，变老的自然过程通常包括能力的变化。如果您遇到与下面描述的相关变化的一些问题，请咨询您的健康专业人员，并确保您采取任何变化和适应措施来帮助您应对和补偿。这个里面第一部分是视觉 vision。Eyes take longer to adjust from dark to light and vice versa, and become more sensitive to glare from sunlight or unshaded light bulbs. There is a decline in intense perception that can make it hard to judge distance, preserving contrasts.And the colors can also be more difficult. Vice versa 是相反的，反之亦然。Glare 是炫光 ，bulbs 是灯泡 ，contrasts 是对比度，相反的。眼睛需要更长的时间来适应从黑暗到明亮，反之亦然，并且对阳光或非屏蔽灯泡的炫光变得更加敏感。深度感知的下降可能使判断距离变得困难，感知对比度和颜色也可能更加困难。第二 ，touch, smell and hearing, 触觉、嗅觉和听力 ，sensitivity to heat, pain and pressure decreases. This makes it more difficult to detect a liquid's temperature.Or changes in ground or floor surfaces. Sense of smell diminishes, making it hard to smell spoiled food, leaking gas, and smoke. Hearing loss can result in difficulty hearing telephones, doorbells, smoke alarms, etc. It can also result in a decreased.Imbalance, which can make falling more likely. 正面人生词 ,sensitivity 是敏感 ,detect 是检测的意思 ,liquids 是液体 ,diminishes 是减弱 ,spoiled food 正面是指是难变质的食物 ,leak 是泄漏这个 etc. 是等等对热、疼痛和压力的敏感性降低，这可能使检测液体的温度或地面或地板表面的变化变得更加困难。嗅觉减弱，更难闻到变质的食物、泄漏的气体和烟雾。听力损失可能导致听力困难、电话、门铃、业务报警器等等。它还可能导致平衡降低，这可能会使跌倒的可能性更大。第三 ，bone density 骨密度 ，bones naturally become less dense and weaker with age. Bone loss, osteoporosis among seniors can be worsened by lack of exercise and nutritional deficiencies. Bone loss can lead to painful fractures, disfigurement, low self-esteem, and a reduction or loss of mobility. Osteoporosis 是骨质疏松症 ，worsened 是恶化 ，deficiency 是缺乏 ，disfigurement 是毁容。Esteem 是自尊 ，reduction 是下降 随着年龄的增长，骨骼自然会变得不那么致密和虚弱，老年人的骨质流失、骨质疏松症可能因缺乏运动和营养缺乏而恶化，骨质流失可能导致疼痛性骨折、毁容、自尊心下降以及活动能力下降或丧失。 Balance and gait， 第四，平衡和步态。 Balance is a complex function involving eyes, inner ear, muscular strength and joint flexibility. Any one of these can change as a result of aging. A general decline in equilibrium can make it more difficult to maintain or recover balance, meaning that a slip or trip can become a fall. The speed of walking, the height to which the heels are lifted, and the length of the person's stride can change with age. These changes can make it more likely for someone to experience a fall. Muscular 是肌肉， equilibrium 是平衡， length 是幅度， stride 是步态。平衡是一项复杂的功能，涉及眼睛、内耳、肌肉力量和关节灵活性，其中任何一个都可能因衰老而改变。均衡的普遍下降会使维持或恢复平衡变得更加困难，这意味着滑倒或绊倒可能成为跌倒。行走的速度、脚后跟被抬起的高度以及一个人的步幅会随着年龄的增长而变化，这些变化可以使某人更有可能经历跌倒。 Memory， 第五，记忆。 In general, sharp brains tend to stay sharp. Cognitive processing and memory may take a bit longer, but this is a normal effect of aging.This is why it's important to make lists and keep phone numbers handy. 一般来说，这里面生词是 sharp 是敏锐， cognitive processing 是认知处理。一般来说，敏锐的大脑往往会保持敏锐，认知处理和记忆可能需要更长的时间，但这是衰老的正常影响。这就是为什么列出清单并保持电话号码很重要的原因。Most seniors develop effective coping mechanisms as they age. Being aware of the normal changes of aging allows you to plan for home and lifestyle adaptations that will help you retain your health, quality of life, and independence. Coping 是应对， mechanisms.是机制， retain 是保持。大多数老年人随着年龄的增长而发展出有效的应对机制。了解衰老的正常变化可以让您计划家庭和生活方式的适应，这将帮助您保持健康、生活质量和独立性。第四部分是 keeping your home safe， 确保您的家安全。Injuries can result from seemingly innocent things around your home, many of which are easily fixed or adapted after you do some detective work to check them down. The following checklists will help you inspect your home for evidence of trouble that may be waiting to happen.Every now answer is a clue that your home may not be as safe as it could be, and that you should be making the needed changes as soon as you can. Your safety depends on it. 受伤，这里面inspect 是检查，没什么生词啊。受伤可能是你由您家周围看似无辜的东西造成的。Innocent 是无辜啊。 其中许多东西在你做了一些检查工作来追踪他们之后，很容易修复或适应。以下清单将帮助你检查房屋，以寻找可能正在等待发生的麻烦的证据。每个不的答案都是一个线索，表明你的家可能不那么安全，你应该尽快做出必要的改变，您的安全取决于它。 Checklist， 这一部分讲的是，第一个是由内而外的检查， Outside， 外面。 Do all your entrances have an outdoor light？ 第一，您所有入口都有户外灯吗？Do your outdoor stairs, pathways, or decks have railings and provide good traction? Example, textured surfaces. 第二，您的户外楼梯、通道或甲板是否有栏杆，并提供良好的牵引力，如纹理表面。这里面生词是栏杆 railing， texture 是纹理表面。第三是 Are the floor steps and walkways around your house in good repair and free of clutter, snow and leaves? 第三，房屋周围的前台阶和人行道是否修复良好，没有杂物、积雪和树叶。 Clutter 是杂物。第四， Do the doorways to your balcony or deck have a low sill or threshold?通往阳台或甲板的门廊是否有低及时或者门槛 ？Sear 是及时门槛 ，threshold 是门槛。第五 ，Can you reach your mailbox safely and easily？ 您可以安全轻松地达到您的邮箱吗？第六 ，Is the number of your house clearly visible from the street and well lit at the night？从街道上可以清楚地看到您房屋的编号，并在晚上光线充足吗？ Lit 是光线啊。提示： If you live in a rural area and don't have a visible house number, make sure your name is on your mailbox and keep a clear description of directions to your home, main roads.Landmarks, etc. By each phone in your house. Description 是描述， landmarks 是地标。如果您住在农村地区，并没有可见的门牌号，请确保您的名字在您的邮箱上，并通过您家中的每部电话清楚地描述您家的方向、主要路道、道路地标等。第二部分是讲的里面 inside。 第一， Are all rooms and hallways in your home well lit？ 您家中的所有房间和走廊是否都光线充足？ Hallways 走廊。第二， Are all through rugs and scatter mats secured in place to keep them from sleep？ 是否所有的地毯和伞布垫都固定到位，以防止滑倒。 Rugs 地毯， Skat mats 是伞的布垫。 Have you removed the skat mats from the top of the stairs and higher traffic areas? 第三，你是否从楼梯顶部的和高活动区域取下了散落的垫子？第四， Are your higher traffic areas clear of obstacles?您的高活动区域是否没有障碍物？ Obstacles 是障碍物。第五， Do you always watch that your pets are not underfoot? 你是否总注意你的宠物不在脚下？第六， If you use floor wax, do you use the non-skid kind? 如果你使用地板蜡，您是否使用防滑的蜡？第七， Do you have a first aid kit and know where it is? 您是否有急救箱，知道它在哪里？ Aid kit 是急救箱。第八， Do you have a list of emergency number near all phones. 您是否在所有电话附近都有紧急号码 列表？提示： Install a seat at the entrance of your home to remove or put on your shoes and boots. 在家门口安装一个座椅，用来脱鞋或者穿靴子。Boots 是靴子。Avoid through rocks and skid mats. They are dangerous. 避免乱扔地毯或垫子，它们很危险。第三部分是 stairs 楼梯。第一个 ，Are your stairways well lit and do you have light switches at the top and bottom of the stairs？ 您的楼梯是否光线充足？楼梯顶部和底部是否有电灯开关？第二。Are your stairs in good repair and free of clutter? 您的楼梯是否维修良好且没有杂物？第三 ，Do the steps of your stairs have a no skip surface? 楼梯的台阶是否有防滑表面 ？No skip 是防滑。第四 ，Are there solid handrails on both sides of the stairway?楼梯两侧是否有坚固的扶手？第五 ，Do you remove your reading glasses when you use the stairs？ 使用楼梯时，你会摘下老花镜吗 ？Tips 提示 ：To help avoid taking a misstep, you can paint wooden or concrete steps with a strip of contrasting color on the edge of each step on the top and the bottom steps. Don't rush going up or down stairs. Rushing is a major cause of falls. 为帮助避免失误，你可以涂木头和混凝土带有对比条的那个楼梯，每个楼梯边缘的颜色或者顶部或底部的楼梯上，不要急于上升或上下楼梯。匆忙是一个主要跌倒的原因。Are your stairs in good repair? 你的楼梯维修的好吗？第四部分是 fire and hazardous materials， 火灾和危险材料。第一 ，Do you have a smoke detector on every floor of your home?您的家的每个楼层都有烟雾探测器吗？第二 ，Do you test your smoke detector every 6 months？ 你是否每六月测试一次烟雾探测器？第三 ，Have you developed an escape route in case of fire and a fire safety plan？ 您是否制定了发生火灾时的逃生路线和消防安全计划？第四。Are you registered on your apartment building's fire safety plan? 你是否在公寓楼的消防安全计划中注册？第五 ，Do you have a carbon monoxide detector in your home? 你家里有一氧化碳探测器吗 ？Monoxide 是一氧化碳。第六 ，Are flammable and hazardous materials clearly labeled and properly stored? 易燃和危险材料是否有清晰的标签并妥善储存 ？Labeled 标签。第七 ，If you use a space heater, is it placed well away from flammable substances and materials?如果你使用空间加热器，它是否远离易燃物质和材料？第八 ，Do you use appropriate power bars to prevent overloading electrical outlets？ 您是否使用适当的电源条来防止电源插座过载 ？Appropriate 是适当的。第九 ，If you live in an old home。Have you or any electrician inspected your wiring, fuse box, electrical codes and appliances for safety. 如果你住在较旧的房屋中，您或您电工是否检查过您的电线、保险丝和电线和电器的安全？ Fuse box 是保险盒，保险丝盒。Appliances 是家用电器啊。第十 ，Do you have a fire extinguisher and know how to use it？ 你是否有灭火器，并知道怎么使用它？提示。To remember to test your smoke detector twice a year. Make a habit of testing it when you turn your clocks forward in the spring and back in the fall. 记得测试你的烟雾，每年两次探测器，每年两次测试这个探测器，烟雾探测器，养成在春季将时钟向前转动，并在秋季返回时进行测试的习惯。第五 ，bathroom 浴室。第一 ，Do you test the water temperature before you get into the bathtub or shower？ 在进入浴缸或淋浴之前，沐浴之前，你是否测试了水温？第二 ，Is your hot water temperature set to the recommended 49 degree， 您的热水温度是否设置建议为49摄氏度？第三 ，Do you have no sleep surfaces in the tub or shower？ 浴缸或淋浴区是否有防滑的表面？第四 ，Do bath mats next to the tub or shower have rubberized backing？Or are they secured in place to keep them from sleeping? 浴缸和淋浴旁边的浴垫是否有橡胶背衬，或者是否固定到位，以防止滑倒 ？Rubberized backing 是橡胶背衬。第五 ，Do you have a night light in the bathroom? 浴室有夜灯吗？第六。Does your bathroom door lock have an emergency release? 您的浴室门锁有紧急释放装置吗？第七 ，Do you have a grab bars that have been probably placed and were anchored to the wall in the bathtub or shower? 您是否有正确的放置并牢固固定在浴缸和淋浴的墙壁的扶手？第八 ，If you have any trouble getting on and off the toilet, do you have a raised toilet seat and a grab bar that is well anchored? 如果您在上下马桶时遇到任何麻烦，您是否有加高的马桶坐垫和锚定良好的扶手？第九 ，If it's difficult for you to take a shower stand up.Have you considered a bath seat? 如果你很难站起来洗澡，你有没有考虑过洗澡座椅？ Do you need raised toilet seat? 你需要加高的马桶盖吗？ Some tile and bath cleaning products actually increase slipperiness. Be careful when use such products.一些瓷砖和浴室清洁产品实际增加滑溜，在以下情况下要小心使用此类产品。 Tile 是瓷砖。请厨房第六部分。第一 Are your pots and pans canned goods and stable foods stored in an easy to reach locationBetween knee and shoulder the heights, 您的锅碗瓢盆、罐头食品和主食是否存放在膝盖和肩部高度之间易于触及的位置？第二 ，a heavy item stored in the lower cupboards and light items in the higher cupboards. 重物事物存放在下部橱柜中，轻质物品存放在较高橱柜中。第三 ，Do you have a stable step stool with a safety rail for reaching higher places? 您是否有稳定的踏脚凳带安全导轨的，可以达到高处？第四 ，Are the off and on positions on the stove dials clearly marked? 炉子刻盘上的关闭和打开的位置是否清晰标明 ？Dials 是一种刻度盘。第五 ，Are your oven mitts within easy reach when you are cooking? 烹饪时你的烤箱手套是否触手可及？第六 ，Do you make sure never to cook while wearing loose-fitting clothes or sleepwear? 你是否确保在穿着宽松的衣服或睡衣时从不做饭？第七 ，Do you have a fire extinguisher in the kitchen mounted on the wall away from the stove? 厨房里有灭火器安装在远离炉子的墙上了吗？第八 ，Do you regularly check that your fire extinguisher is in good operating order?您是否定期检查您的灭火器是否良好的操作顺序 ？Tips 提示 ：Use heat-resistant oven mitts rather than pot holders. They provide a better grip on hot containers and give you better.Protection against splatters and steam. If you do experience a burn, immerse in cool water, not ice or butter. 使用耐烤箱手套而不是锅架，它们为热容器提供很好的抓地力，并给予您可以更好的防止飞溅和蒸汽。如果你确实经历过烧伤，请沉浸在冷水。而不是冰或者黄油 ，splatters 是飞溅 ，immerse 是沉浸在里面。Are your oven mitts in a handy location? 你的烤箱手套在一个方便的地方吗？第七 ，bedroom 卧室。第一 ，Is there a light switch near the entrance to your bedroom? 卧室入口附近有电灯开关吗？第二。Do you have a lamp or light switch near your bed? 您的床边有台灯或电灯开关吗？第三 ，Do you keep light nights or other source of light on in case you get up in the middle of the night? 您是否保持夜间灯或其他光源亮起，以防您在半夜起床？第四。Is there a clear path from your bed to the bathroom? 从床上到浴室有清晰的路径吗？第五 ，Do you have a phone and a list of emergency phone numbers near your bed? 你的床边是否有紧电话或紧急的电话号码列表 ？Tips 提示 ：Make sure your bed is not too high or low.So that it is easy to get in or out of it. You can purchase short bed rails to steady yourself when getting out of bed. 确保你的床不是太高或太低，这样就很容易进出。你可以购买短床杆以稳定起床时的自己。Is there a clear path from your bed to the bathroom? 从床上到浴室有清晰的路径吗？第八个是 garage, basement and workroom, 车库、地下室和工作室。第一 ，Are your workroom and laundry room well lit? 你的工作室和洗衣房光线充足吗？第二 ，Do you have a telephone in the basement and a list of emergency phone numbers? 地下室是否有电话？有电话和列表紧急电话号码。 第三 ，Do you keep floors and benches clean and clean to reduce fire and tripping hazards？ 你是否保持地板或墙和墙面清洁，以减少火灾和绊倒的危险？第四 ，Are all your tools and services equipment in good condition？ Are the safety locks on？您的所有工具和维修设备是否处于良好状态？安全锁是否打开？第五 ，Is there work area well ventilated summer and winter？ 您的工作区域是否通风良好？冬季和夏季 ，ventilated 是通风良好。第六 ，Are heavy items on lower shelves or in bottom cupboards？重是在较低的架子上或者在底部的橱柜中。第七 Do you use a ladder or a stable step stool with a safety rail for reaching higher places? 您是否使用梯子或稳定的踏脚凳带安全导轨的为了达到高处？第八Are all chemicals such as bleach, cleaners, and painting thinners clearly identified? 所有的化学品、漂白剂、清洁剂和油漆稀释剂明确标识了吗？ Bleach 是漂白剂。第九 Are flammable materials stored asIndicated by the directions on the label and away from source of heat and flame. 易燃的材料是否按照说明存放在标签上，并远离热源和火焰？第十 ，If you have a gas barbecue, is your propane tank stored outside of the house? 如果您有燃气烤炉。您的丙烷罐是否储存在室外？ Tips 提示： When you use a ladder, never stand or sit on the top three rungs. Maintain your balance by keeping your body centered between the rails, not reaching to the sides and not pushing or pulling on anything. 使用梯子时切勿站立或坐在顶部三级，通过保持您的主体位于导轨之间，不触及侧面，不要推或拉任何东西。Childproofing 儿童安全 ，a must for doting grandparents 一个必须的，对于溺爱的祖父母。第一 ，Have you removed items from your lower surfaces to prevent？Brick edge injury and spears. 您是否从下面移出物品以防止破损、受伤或溢出？第二 ，child resistant capers are not childproof. Are all medications and pill boxes stored out of the reach of children? 儿童防护帽不是儿童保护的。所有药物和存放在儿童接触不到的地方的药盒。第三 ，Are household products and chemicals such as cleaning products, painting thinners, and alcohol stored and locked in a cupboard that is out of the reach of children？ 是否家用产品和化学品，如清洁产品？油漆稀释剂和酒精储存并锁在橱柜中，这是儿童无法触及的吗？第四 ，Are cosmetic products such as nail polish remover creams, mouthwash, and perfumes out of the reach of children？化妆品如指甲油、去除剂、面霜、漱口水和香水，儿童都接触不到吗？第五 ，Have you stored a small object out of the sight and reach of younger children to prevent choke？ 您是否将小物体存放在看不见和接触不到的地方，防止年幼的孩子窒息。第六， Have you stored lighters, matches and candles out of the sight and reach of children? 您是否将打火机、火柴和蜡烛存放在视线之外和儿童接触的地方？第七， Have you installed safety catchers on your cupboards and medicine cabinet doors? 您是否在橱柜上安装了 安全锁扣以及药柜门？第八， Have you purchased safety gates for stairs or unsafe rooms? 你是否为楼梯或不安全的房间购买了安全门？第九， Is there a safety latch on your stove and dishwasher? 您的炉灶和洗碗机上是否有安全门栓？门栓这里是 latch。 第十， Are extension telephone and lantern blind cords out of children's way? 分机电话和软百叶窗线是否脱落在儿童道的地方？第十一， Are your garage and workroom locked with deadbolts installed? 您的车库和车间是否安装了门栓锁定在高的地方？提示： If you have a pool or if there's one in the building where you live, exercise extra vigilance. Make sure the pool is absolutely off limits to children by installing safety devices on house doors leading to the pool and a very high latch on the pool fence gates. Never leave any child without supervision. Latch 是门锁， vigilance 是警惕。如果您有一个游泳池，或者您住的地方建造断裂极限，要警惕，确保游泳池绝对通过安装安全装置，禁止儿童进入通往游泳池的房门上的设备，还有游泳池围栏上一个非常高的栓锁门，永远不要让任何孩子没有监督。这第二部分是艾琳的故事， Ellen's story. When Ellen Shannon was taking care of her lying mother-in-law, she decided to get rubber bath installed in the bathroom. She also got a bath seat. She was pretty familiar with safety devices and she knew her mother-in-law needed the support in the bathroom. Now, several years later, Ellen is surprised to find herself using those same grab bars. Although Ellen is fairly healthy, she did have two unexpected bouts of illness. I thought I'm 69. I won't need those things. But when you get ill and you come back from the hospital and you are weak, you are mightily glad to have that bar on the bathtub wall. Ellen's house has other safety features that she installed and finds handy, such as improved lighting, night lights, and lever tips that are easy to turn. As she lives in a large house and her home is a place where everyone gathers for family get-togethers, she has also child-proofed the rooms. When she looks ahead to the future, she sees herself remaining in this house safely for a long time to come. 里面生词 align 是疾病、生病的意思， boats 是发作， taps 是水龙头。 当埃琳香农照顾她的疾病死的岳母时，她决定在浴室安装扶手，她还得到了一个洗澡座椅。她很熟悉了，有了这些安装安全装置，她知道她的婆婆需要浴室的支撑。几年后的今天，艾琳惊讶地发现自己在使用同样的扶手。艾琳相当健康，但她确实有两次意外意想不到的疾病发作。我想我69岁，我不需要这些东西，但当你生病时，你从医院回来，你很虚弱，你很高兴浴室安装扶手。艾琳的房子还有其他安全功能，她安装并觉得方便，如改善照明、夜灯和易于旋转动的移动水龙头。如他住在一个大房子里，他的家就是每个人都聚集在一起参加家庭聚会的地方。他还对房间进行了儿童保护。当展望未来，他看到自己安全地留在这所房子里很长一段时间的时候来了。今天的课就到这里，还有下面一部分下一次课再讲。